Hey friends, okay, so today's video, I'm gonna be talking about five ways that you can grow closer to Mother Mary. If you are new here, I would love to have you subscribe down below, be a part of this community, this awesome community. I wanted to do this video to kind of have like little cliff notes of if you are trying to get closer to Mother Mary, some ways that you can grow closer to Mother Mary. This video is for you because here's the thing, Mother Mary wants to get close to you. A lot of people say, I feel Mary tugging in my heart and I feel like she wants to, you know, be my friend and she wants to be my mother and I don't know how to get closer to her. And so this is just like five really easy, simple ways. I actually do have a bonus, ways that you can grow closer to Mother Mary and get to know her better. I do wanna say, whenever I do a Mary video, I always wanna say that a lot of people, Protestants in particular, think that we worship Mother Mary, and that is such a disservice. We do not worship Mother Mary. The Catholic faith, we honor her, we love her for her yes to Jesus. It's because of her yes to God that we get to go to heaven through Jesus. And Mother Mary just wants all of us to get to know her son because she's so proud and she loves her son so much. So these are just some devotions, ways to pray, different books, different ways to grow closer to Mother Mary. So I'm just gonna start off really basic. Like the first thing is to talk to her, to pray and ask Mother Mary. So pray is when you are talking with somebody, that is what prayer is. So we want to pray and just like talk to Mother Mary like she's our best friend or our mother. I know a lot of people say they don't have a good relationship with their mother has passed away, or maybe you're like me and I absolutely love my mother, but Mother Mary, like there's just something so special about her. And I've always felt like she has pursued me my entire life. And even if you don't feel like Mother Mary is pursuing you, she is. She absolutely is, because on the cross, Jesus gave his mother to all of us. He said, "This is your mother, you know, take her into your home." Through that, he gave us his mother. And so we should be taking her into our home and loving her and having a relationship with her, just the way that we do with our mother. And that's the thing, like you can talk to her like she's your best friend or your mother, because she really is. Like she, if you feel like she's pursuing you in your heart, she probably is, big time. And if you don't feel that way, trust me, she's still pursuing you. She loves all of you so, so much. And she is our mother. So talk to her like she's your mom and just tell her about your day, tell her about your concerns, you know, just ask for her help, her guidance. Because Jesus said, wherever two or more are gathered in my name, there I am. You know, and how could Jesus deny his mother anything? You know, I mean, that's biblical, right? Honor your mother and father. And so if we have Mary praying with us, then how could God deny that, you know, and stuff. So anyway, and we do not worship Mary in no way. Like that would be a mortal sin. That would be a very bad sin. But we do ask her to pray with us and to help us. Anyway, so talk to her like she is your mother, because she is, even more so than your mom. The second thing is, I'm not gonna go in like a specific order, but miraculous medal. So I have videos actually on almost all of these, so I will link them below if you want me to go more in depth. But this is the miraculous medal. I never take it off. The only time I do is when I went for my C-section with Maria Grace and all my children, is the only time I took off my miraculous medal. I take a shower in it, everything. Somebody asked, I used to have a gold medal. I still have it, but Maria Grace broke it, of course. So I have this, I got it for Christmas, and it's like, it's three fake diamonds and a pearl. And so that's all I have. And so that's what the chain that I'm using, because that's all I have. So I have a silver miraculous medal as well. And this medal, so the reason we wear this medal is because it's kind of like putting on protection. It is not superstition or anything like that. This actually, Mother Mary promised that she would protect us and guide us. And actually, people who have put on this medal, so you want to get it blessed first, but people who have put on this medal, conversions that have happened, people, like the reason it's called miraculous medal is because miracles have happened with people who wear this medal. Like, it is very powerful and just an amazing thing. So whenever we put this medal on, it's like it's like Mary is wrapping us in her arms and protecting us from Satan, from spiritual warfare, things like that. So I have a whole video on that. So I will put link that down below where I go more in depth about where the medal came from and all of that. Okay, so the third one that I would recommend is that you do a consecration to Mary. This one is the 33 days to Morning Glory. And then there's also St. Louis de Montfort. He has the total consecration to Mary. And so what it is it's kind of, it's a book, as you can see, and you're kind of learning about Mother Mary. So if you really want to learn about Mother Mary, these books are awesome. And then at the end, you consecrate yourself to her. You pretty much say, Mother Mary. It's almost like being in, you know, a baby being in her mother's arms, right? That's pretty much when you consecrate yourself to Mary, you're saying, take care of me. Like, be my mother, take care of me, lead me to God, help me to be a holy person the way that you were holy and you said yes to God, help me to be like that. Because Mary wants nothing more than for you to get to heaven and praise God, worship God for eternity. So this book I love because it really kind of walks you through like learning about Mother Mary more. The total consecration from St. Louis de Montfort is really good. It's a lot more intense. So if you want to go a lot deeper, definitely get the St. Louis de Montfort one. I have it. I can't find it right now. This one, for me being a mommy of five kids, this is what the one I choose to do. It's a lot more easier to understand and just like easy read type of thing. And so the thing about the total consecration, I have a whole video on this as well, but there's certain days that you start the consecration, and it says in the book, like it tells you, because you're gonna want, like it ends on one of her feast days. So you start 33 days before her feast day pretty much. And it just, you know, day one, day two, day 31. So you just read each day, and then on the 33rd day you consecrate yourself. So highly recommend getting the book, even if you don't want to consecrate yourself and you're like, I don't quite know what that is, I don't want to like do something that, you know, if you're not quite sure, you know, if you're like, that's a Catholic thing, I don't know, it sounds kind of weird, you can read it and not consecrate yourself. I highly recommend consecrating yourself because you're just like pretty much saying, you know, take care of me, Mother. You know, like that's pretty much all it is. So third one, consecrate yourself to Mother Mary, or at least read the book and get to know her better. The fourth one is the Holy Rosary. I mean, the days that I pray the rosary and the days that I don't and do are completely different. My days that I pray the rosary are much more grace-filled. I am a better mother, a better wife. So I highly recommend praying every single day. If you don't know how to pray the rosary, I have videos on that as well. Or you can legit just pray with me. I have videos where I'm praying and you just follow along. But there's so many promises that Mother Mary has promised if we pray the rosary, that she will help us get to heaven and answer our prayers. I have a whole video on her promises as well. I will link that below as well. I have a lot of Marian videos because I absolutely love her so much. And thankfully I have loved her for as long as I can remember. My mother gave me the best gift, and that was teaching me the rosary at a very young age and helping me to have a deeper relationship with Mother Mary. So I highly, highly recommend praying a rosary every day if you can, maybe three or four, but try to do a rosary. Okay, the fifth one is the first Saturdays. So Mary appeared to three children in Fatima, Francesco, Lucia, and Jacinta, and asked them as I think Lucia specifically, to do the first Saturday. So every first Saturday, you go to Mass, go to confession, pray the rosary, and then meditate for 15-20 minutes on the mysteries of the rosary. So the rosary is pretty much a scriptural, it's pretty much the scripture. And so anyway, so she asked Lucia to do the first Saturdays, and then Jesus revealed to her later on why the first Saturdays. And pretty much what it is for people who have hurt and offended Mother Mary. Like, imagine if, you know, your child were to, you know, call you horrible names and do mean things to you. So it's kind of like that. Like Mother Mary, when we look at Mother Mary, we should always see a mother when we see her. And there's so many people who are against Mother Mary and who have just said mean things, blasphemous things. And what the First Saturday is pretty much soothing Mother Mary. You know, we are soothing her and telling her we love her, we're on your side, we will defend you, we love you. There's a lot of promises with those as well. A lot of the devotions you'll notice are, there's a lot of promises that go with them. And pretty much it's just an encouragement for you and I to pray is what these promises are. To go to Mass, to go to confession, to pray the rosary. Like, if we cling to those things, like, we can go so high in our spiritual lives. Those three things: confession, Mass, and the rosary. So that's the first Saturday. I have a whole video on that as well. I will link that below. And then the bonus one that I want to say is Marian apparitions and Marian books. So Mary has appeared to so many people throughout history, and a lot of the times she will appear to kind of prepare people for things that are to come. And, you know, just as like I want to prepare my children for going to the next grade in school or whatever, she wants to prepare us for things that might be a jarring to us, so that when things happen, we are prepared. Like, we have the grace, we're it's okay. So a lot of Marian apparitions have happened throughout history and throughout the world. Fatima's a great one, a great Marian apparition that happened. Also, there's Lourdes with Saint Bernadette, and so those were kind of a little bit farther off. There's Our Lady of Cabejo. This book is phenomenal. It's super easy read. It's like Mary appeared to children before the genocide happened in Rwanda, and it's amazing. Like, in this book, a lot of, I think, I can't remember how many girls, but there were so many girls at this Catholic school that Mary appeared to, and they all, you know, were tested and all of this stuff. And they always are. Anyway, Mary appeared to them and pretty much was preparing them, like, okay, like, you need to pray, pray, pray. A genocide will happen if you don't pray, you know, and all of this stuff. So anyway, it's their story. It's the story of before the genocide happened and how Mary tried so hard to prepare people for it. Also, there's very interesting stories about them. Like, some of the children got to go to heaven, hell, and purgatory, and you get to, like, they talk about that, and it's just, it's amazing. Like, this is one of my top five Catholic books ever. Like, it is so, so good. It was in, like, one of my other videos, my top five books I will never get rid of. I love it. It took me a long time to read because I did not want it to end. Like, I knew what the ending would be, but I just, like, I love the writing and I loved it so much. So anyway, this is like one of my best favorite books. And it's about Mother Mary and Rwanda. And this was when I was alive, right? This was the 1980s, I think this happened. So this has happened within our lifetime. They still are saying that there are different apparitions and stuff that have happened. So anyway, so I would look into the apparitions. They have movies, The Song of Bernadette, the Kids of Fatima have movies as well. Like, there's a lot of really good ones. The Song of Bernadette, hands down the best Marian movie ever, I think. So those are just some ways. Also, I wanted to share with you, so there's a couple books. Scott Hahn wrote a book. I thought I had a copy, maybe I don't. Hail Holy Queen, I think is the name of it. He is phenomenal. He used to be Protestant, converted to the, a Protestant pastor, converted to Catholicism, and is very knowledgeable about scripture and everything. Phenomenal. So that book, I'll link everything down below that I can. This one is so awesome too. The Imitation of Mary. So there's The Imitation of Christ, which is one of my favorite books as well. And then there's this one. This is The Imitation of Mary. And it just, you get to know Mother Mary on such a great level. It also has the rosary in there, the different mysteries, but it's so good. So if you're looking for a Marian book, like prayer book, this one will really help and inspire you. So anyway, I hope that this video helped you. I just want to like cliff notes of, okay, I want to get to know Mother Mary. I want to dive in with my relationship with her. What do I do? These are the things I would recommend for you. If you can think of any other ones that I might have missed, definitely write them down in the comments section so other people can get to know Mother Mary. I will link whatever I can, even like maybe videos or things that might help you to grow closer to Mother Mary and stuff. So anyway, until next time, I will see you all later. God bless. Bye.